Welcome. In this video we will show you how to enable axis constraints when snapping in 3ds Max. Axis constraints restrict the transforms to take place along one or two axes. Constraining helps to avoid transforming an object in an undesired position. Visually, in 3ds Max, when axis constraints are enabled, a circle appears in the center point of the pivot. If you wonder why your pivot does not show a circle, then you're in the right place. As always, there are a bunch of different ways to access the settings in 3ds Max, so in this video, we've decided to show you two ways to enable axis constraints. First things first. We'll make a few standard primitives, so we can show you how constraints are set by default. So, when we try to move an object without axis constraints enabled, we cannot restrict the movement to the axis we want, but instead, we end up moving all over the world. One way to enable axis constraints is to do it from the grid and snap settings. The fastest way to access those settings is by right-click on Snap's toggle button. When the grid and snap settings dialog appears, navigate to the Options panel. In the translation section, check Enable Axis Constraint and close the dialog window. The shortcut to enable axis constraint is Alt plus F3. The other way to enable axis constraints is from the Axis Constraint toolbar. The toolbar is not displayed in 3ds Max by default, so in order to display it, we need to go and right-click on an empty spot on the main toolbar and click on Axis Constraint in the drop-down menu. The toolbar can be set anywhere we want, or we can just leave it to float. The button on the right is Enable Axis Constraints. Make sure that the button is highlighted, otherwise it is disabled, and you will not be able to restrict to a constraint. From the toolbar we can restrict the transforms to a specified axis. Only one axis constraint can be active at a time. Moving the object from the viewport changes the constraints, as soon as we click on one of the axes from the gizmo. The shortcuts for the constraints are the following. F5 restricts to X axis. F6 restricts to Y axis. F7 restricts to Z-axis. And F8 cycles throughout the plane restrictions. Now you know how to enable axis constraints in 3ds Max. Thank you for watching this video. We hope it was helpful. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to share your thoughts in the comments section below. See you in the next video.